On an HCDC unit, a fault code 8 indicates the blower has not been interpreted correctly by the main circuit board. The problem is either the blower or the motor itself. In this case here, we're going to show you a brief methodology to replace the blower and check the main board at the same time. Remove the screws that are in the cabinet to open up the front face. And remove the cover. Once the cover is removed, go ahead and check the connections on the gas valve and verify that they're intact. You can reset the fault code at this time by pressing the far right button, the reset button, and try the blower motor again. When fault code 8 does appear, you've now identified the connections were good. Let's go ahead and remove the blower motor and replace it. Once you've removed the blower, it's important to understand there's one blower motor that fits 12 of the 13 SKUs of this series boiler. Important to that fact is when you go to replace the motor, there's a venturi that must be removed from the old blower housing and reinserted into the new one. Once the fan has been removed from the HC or DC series unit, you will need to replace the venturi located in the bottom of the blower from the original to the replacement. It's a very simple process, but it does take a little bit of effort. So turn the blower over and remove the key that holds the gas line and venturi in place. Put it aside for later use. Remove the gas line by pulling down. Next, you'll need to remove the venturi, but the venturi is very snug. With that in mind, have a tool available to grab the tang of the venturi and pull straight out. Once this venturi is removed, you will find to go and reinsert it into the new unit. It is keyed. It'll only fit one direction. Once you find the appropriate orientation, push it tight till it goes all the way to the bottom. But it may not be deep enough to put the key in at this point in time. So take a tool and lightly tap on the venturi till it's inserted all the way. Install your gas line into the center of the venturi. The O-ring creates the seal and lock it in using the key and the pin to hold it.